If you were Roger Ramjet, what would you do if your government called you in to solve the mystery of the flying saucers invading Earth from outer space? Probably you'd try to live through a perilous escapade, just like this one. And here we go. Every corner of the round sphere was being deluged with flying saucers.
This flying saucer situation is abominable. It is very bad, gentlemen. And being a benevolent sort of country, we've got to do something about it.
Let's pass a law against it.
A law.
No, we'll turn the problem over to Roger Ramjet.
Good thinking, your generalship.
And so as the onslaught from outer space continued, Roger Ramjet was called in to do something about the whirling mess.
Ramjet, you always cease to amaze me.
And as the general briefed Roger as to the nature of the problem, Roger said...
Huh? You mean there are thousands of flying saucers, but we've never captured one? Never seen one up close?
Affirmative.
Well, first thing, we've got to catch us one of those things.
And he did! Right in the head!
Now that irritates me. Say, wait a minute. This is a saucer, a flying saucer.
And so the mystery of the flying saucers was revealed. They were not spaceships, just regular saucers. But Roger wondered...
Where do they come from?
And he wondered...
Why are they here?
And he wondered...
How do we get rid of them?
And as Roger continued to wonder, the saucers continued to fly about the world, causing a great amount of trouble to the natives.
You are breaking the speed law.
Oh! I'm sorry I'm late, dear. I hope you're not angry.
Okay, Buster, here's where you get the famous crunch punch.
Roger Ramjet had really better hurry before the entire world is knocked out.
Gosh, Roger, what do you make of the saucer mystery?
I think it should be solved. No question about it.
But how, Roger? We don't even know where they're coming from.
If we can get to our planes, maybe we can fly above the saucers and find out where they're coming from.
And that's just what they did.
Roger, it looks like they're coming from another planet.
Dan was right. The saucers were coming from another planet. Quickly, Roger devised a plan and told General Brassbottom about it.
Then you say you want me to give you a rocket ship so you can go to this mysterious planet and stop the saucers?
Unless you have a better idea, General.
I guess the best way is just to follow this trail of saucers. It should take me right to the planet. I wonder how far it
is. This must be the place, all right. The saucers seem to be coming from over there. Hello there. I'm Roger Ramjet. What are you shooting those saucers all over my Earth for?
Saucers? What do you talk? These are seconds.
Seconds?
Yeah, we've been trying to invent the wheel and we keep blowing it. They aren't coming out right.
So rather than let these bad wheels pile up around here, we throw them out. We just can't seem to invent a good wheel.
Inventing the wheel, eh? Perhaps I can help.
Oh, for joy, for joy.
But if I show you how to make the wheel, will you stop shooting those saucers at my planet?
You betcha, Red Rider.
And so that's exactly what happened. With the American hero ingenuity which was inbred in his head, Roger Ramjet set to work and made the cavemen from Planet X a perfect wheel.
We're very grateful, Roger. We won't ever shoot flying saucers at you again.
Happy I could help, gentle cavemen.
And so Roger Ramjet has done it again. Saved the world from a lot of bruises.
Boy, now we got a wheel.
Right. Now let's get started on inventing fire, should we?
But what happens next, you won't believe.